Welcome to the video tutorial on how to create an OpenVPN server on the OPNsense firewall. The OpenVPN server helps client Windows computers connect to the local network from anywhere. Not only Windows computers, OpenVPN supports other operating systems such as Android, iOS or Linux. In this example, after completing the OpenVPN server creation, I use a Windows computer connected to the local network via the Internet. Let's get started. First of all, to create an OpenVPN connection, I configure a certificate to ensure trust between the server and client. I create an authority which you will find under System Trust Authority. You follow these steps. I set the period to 10 years to avoid having to renew at short notice. Then you add your descriptive information. After completing adding authority, add a new certificate. Choose the Just Create Authority and Certificate Authority. In this step, you create a certificate for the OpenVPN server, so you set the type to server. I also set the time here to 10 years. After completing the certificate creation for the server, I created a new account and certificate for it. I created a new account with the username test1. Next, I create a new certificate for the newly created account. This is a certificate for the client, so you set the type to client. After I finished creating the certificates, I created the OpenVPN server. The above scheme is the subnets I set up for the OpenVPN tunnel. Client Windows computers access internal network resources through the OpenVPN tunnel. The following are the steps to configure OpenVPN on OPNsense. I generate a static key for OpenVPN. You create a new static key as follows. It will be used to configure the OpenVPN server. After completing the static key, I create a server instance. OpenVPN uses the UDP protocol and listens on port 1194. Next, I set up the subnet for the OpenVPN tunnel. I set up the subnet as shown on the diagram. Here I use a certificate for the VPN server. Next, I use the static key just created in the previous step. These are the steps to create an OpenVPN server on OPNsense, but there are a few more steps to follow. I created a new interface on OPNsense. It helps me set up firewall rules. The new interface is called OpenVPN. If you do not configure permissions on the firewall, clients cannot connect to the OpenVPN server. So I created a new rule that allows clients to connect to the OpenVPN server. I allow the UDP protocol to use port 1194 through the OPNsense 1 interface. But for clients to access resources on the internal network, you need to create a new rule. I allow the OpenVPN tunnel subnet to access other subnets on OPNsense. Thus, the client can access resources in the local network. So I have completed creating the certificate, completing the OpenVPN server configuration and creating rules in the firewall. Next, I export the configuration file for the OpenVPN client. This file is sent to the client Windows computer to connect to the OpenVPN server from anywhere. In this case, the client connects to the server using the public IP address on the OPNsense 1 interface. In the next part, I show you how to connect using the domain name of the dynamic domain name service. After obtaining the configuration file for the client, you send it using email, external hard drive, or any other way. But don't let this file fall into the wrong hands to ensure the safety of your network. This is the Windows computer I use as the OpenVPN client. This computer already had other OpenVPN software installed. I just imported the configuration file from the previous step. You are required to enter a username and password to connect to the OpenVPN server. The connection was successful, and this is the IP address I set up for the OpenVPN tunnel. I will connect to a Windows computer on the local network to check the results. I use remote desktop to control one of the Windows computers on the local network. Above are the steps to create an OpenVPN server on OPNsense. You can create additional certificates and accounts if you want to have more different clients. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. As mentioned, next I introduce how to connect to OpenVPN server using dynamic domain name service. This solves the problem when you use a dynamic public IP address. The public IP address will change over time and make it difficult for you to connect to the VPN server. On OPNsense, you install dynamic DNS client. It requires me to update to a newer OS version for OPNsense. So I updated OPNsense. After completing the update, I installed dynamic DNS client. This plugin helps me configure various dynamic domain services. In this case, I use a service called DuckDNS. You just need to update your token and domain name to configure a dynamic domain name on OPNsense. Your public IP address will be checked every 5 minutes. Next, you just need to change the configuration file to connect to the OpenVPN server using a dynamic domain name. Or you can create a new client configuration file that uses the domain name. Good luck! On the client Windows computer, I edit the configuration file as follows. So instead of using a public IP address, I use a dynamic domain name to connect to the OpenVPN server.